Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode in my Minecraft survival world. Today, we are going to be making ourselves a little bit of a sheep farm. That's right, we're going to be making a sheep farm, and this is going to be really cool and really, really necessary. And you might be wondering why I'm saying that, because I've got a fully functioning sheep farm right behind me in the distance over there. And the reason is that, well, this sheep farm only has four different types of colours of wool. It has black, white, grey, and light grey. That's not enough. That's not enough for all my projects, because in the future I might want to be building things out of wool, you know. I like wool. It's good to have things colourful, and maybe I'll be building, making some more carpets and things, and putting carpets around my world in different places. Who knows what I'll be doing in the future. Also, in the last project that I was making, in one of the last projects, when I was making the storage system for the Iron Titan, I used some banners there. I used some cyan banners, and that cost a lot of wool, and I actually had to go running around all the way around the area to try and find some white sheep to actually get the wool from, because I didn't have enough white sheep inside that pen. So that's really annoying. I'm going to have to go and make a proper sheep farm this time, and make one which will give me a ton of different varieties of different colours of wool, which is going to be really, really useful. But apart from that, I've also got a little bit of news and information for these videos for the Adventures in Minecraft series on this channel, and that is that the episodes will definitely be shortening. The episodes will probably be cut from about 3/4 of an hour or a half an hour to about 20 minutes, because that makes sense. I don't think many people are watching right now. Many people aren't watching these videos because they're a bit too long, and to be honest, if I was seeing a new channel which I hadn't subscribed to and I saw an episode that's about 40 minutes long, then I probably wouldn't watch it. So I'm probably going to shorten down the time and make it into 20 minutes, but there is also another big and fundamental reason for that, and that's because I'm going to be starting college very soon, in the near future now. There's a matter of like a week or something to go, roughly, and that means that YouTube is probably going to take a big hit because of that. It's going to, you know, the episodes are going to be uploaded less frequently, and they're already not uploaded very frequently anyway. But I'm going to make a change on that, because these episodes are going to be slightly shorter. It's going to mean that it's going to be easier to actually make the episodes. I'm going to have more time to produce them. But obviously, college is going to take a lot of work and time and effort, and a lot of energy is going to go into that as well. So I've got to sort of balance things out. And I've also picked like the hardest subjects, which is just, I know it's a bit stupid, but I need to do well academically as well. So I've picked pretty much the hardest subjects, and that will take a hit on YouTube. But without further ado, if I actually want to make this episode pretty short, then I should probably end this cut right here, and we'll get straight into the episode. So a little bit earlier on, I went into my creative world and tried to come up with some design ideas, and I actually came up with four big designs, four or five actually, and built them out and experimented with different techniques of getting into the sheep pens and coming up, coming in from above, and having kind of a bridge going along, and I liked that idea. But all of the designs that I made, I wasn't happy with a single one of them. They were all really kind of, the aesthetics didn't look very nice. They used cobblestone and oak wood, and nothing really seemed to work out very well. And even though I like come up with so many different designs, I don't think I'm going to use any of them. I think I'm just going to go in this area, which is where I'm probably going to be building this thing, and I'm just going to go like freestyle. I'm just not going to bother with the creative stuff, creating everything in creative mode. So I've gone ahead, removed this section of the wall right here, and now what I've got to do is dig out a nice space for this thing to be. So what I'm thinking is I'm not going to have too many different colours. I'm not going to have all 16 different wall types, or how many there are. I think there are about 16, but I'm not going to have 16, because that would mean lots and lots of lag, pretty much. See, when Assume Void built his sheep farm, his main massive sheep farm on Hermitcraft, he built it out in the sea, because that's where you get the least amount of lag, pretty much. But for me, this area is going to be like my main area that I go to all the time, so I don't want any lag here. And what I'm going to have to do to reduce that is just have less different types of sheep. I'm going to have lots and lots of white wool sheep, because obviously you can dye white wool in whichever way you want, which means that white wool is the most useful out of all the wools. And then the other wools, or the other cheap colors. Basically, it will probably be light gray, and then red and blue and stuff like that. Just the main colors that I may or may not need in the future. But I can't have all of them, unfortunately. If this was an ideal world, I would probably try and like get all 16 different colors and sort of line them up. And I was planning to do something like that, but the only problem is I want to make the pens pretty big. I don't want them to be small pens because I want to be able to get a good amount of wool from each pen. Say I'm just needing blue wool or something, I need to go and get like at least a stack, if not a little bit more, that would be even better. So I'm going to need to make pretty big pens. And the first thing I need to do is again dig this area out, and it's probably going to be a long lengthwise build. So there are going to be loads of different modules, or not modules, but pens basically, for the different types of wool. I'll probably have about, I'm not really sure, maybe five, six different types of colors, wool colors, but I'll have to pick which ones I want later on. But I'll just make the pens right now anyway. So I should probably get on with that, and then I will be back. Much of the digging out has been done, but unfortunately, about my 15th axe or something, or sorry, not axe, my spade has broken. And look, I've still got loads of dirt in here as well. I'm getting a bit clogged up with my inventory, and I should probably figure out, I should probably move all of this dirt away from here, but I'll probably keep some of it here anyway. But we've still got a little bit left to do, just that extension bit there up to that corner, and then creating ourselves a little bit of a rectangle here. But I've got a new idea instead of the lengthwise thing that I was talking about before, because we've got quite a large area here, and I think it would be really nice to create a fair amount of pens. But so what I'm thinking is actually creating a grid pattern. So we'll have like one pen right here, one pen here, and then one pen in that area, and they'll obviously be all evened out. I haven't actually counted any of the blocks or anything. I've just been digging out pretty much randomly to create an area for the sheep farm. But yeah, we'll have three pens there, three pens along in the middle, and three pens on that side there. I think it will be three. I don't know, because I haven't measured anything out. I don't know how many pens will fit and how big each one will be. But I'm just going to have to experiment around and count the number of sides and things and do that. And then figure out the positions of everything, and then lay down the foundations for these things. But the one thing that I do know is this grass right here is going to be the grass, which is literally going to be inside the pen. So sheep are going to be on top of this level, but then we're going to construct stuff around that. And we're probably going to have two walkways, one running this way all the way to the end, and another one running from here all the way to the end. And those two are going to allow you to get into each of the pens. And I don't know how that's going to be, like how you actually get in there, because I want a really cool kind of unorthodox kind of thing where you kind of have to. I had this idea, and I did this in my creative world. You have one block floating up like this, and then you have ladders on each of the blocks, or each of the faces, and then you can climb up onto there, and it will probably go a bit two blocks up in the air, I think. Wow, I almost sounded Scottish there. Go about two blocks into the air. Yeah, I'm not going to do my Scottish accent. That doesn't really work very well, especially when I'm recording. But yeah, that's going to take you up onto the platforms or the walkways, and then you can go and sort of fall down into the sheep pens. Do your business. Get all of the wool from them. Shear all of the sheep. I don't want any redstone systems or any water pushing them anywhere or anything like that. I'm going to keep this as simple and traditional as possible, like most of the other farms and things in this area. So then you climb up the ladder, and then you come back onto the platform. This is all very hard to visualize right now, probably. So I'm going to start building out the template and dig out all of the rest of that area, and then I'll show you what I've came up with. It has been an extremely, extremely long time since the last cut, and usually when I say that, it's just been like a day or something, or a few days, but this has been more than a few days, probably about 4 days or something, I don't know. But I'm really enjoying this project so far, and as you can see, I've dug out the entire area. Couldn't talk properly then, that I was talking about in the last cut, and I even extended it further than it was before, and I only extended it because I wanted like an equal number of blocks, or an odd number of blocks actually, so I could sort of set out equal boundaries for these pens, which is exactly what I've done. As you can see, all of the wooden logs here are pretty much permanent. What they're going to be are the framework of the pens, and you can see we have, I think, 9 pens over here, 3 this way, 3 that way, and 1 in the middle. So we have like a lot of space for sheep, but only 9 pens, which is exactly what I wanted. I wanted lots of space for lots of sheep, so we could get lots of a certain wool color, if you get what I mean. But I wanted less pens, so I had less lag. And that is probably going to work out with this design. And the way this is going to work, by the way, is going to be something along the lines of this. So this strip here and this strip right over here, they are going to like have walkways going across at this level, at this grass block level, going all the way to the other side, and they're probably going to be like what supported, yeah, probably one block higher on these wooden posts. I'm going to extend these posts up, and I'm going to have them walkways going all the way along. And then the way it's going to work is I'm going to have pillars like this on either side going up, and then I'm going to have ladders on the sides of these pillars, and that means you can easily go into your pen and then get out of there, take your wool, whatever you need to do, and get out of there really quickly and easily. I hope I haven't actually already explained this in the last cut and I'm just repeating it. If I am, I'm very sorry. I haven't been recording for quite a while, and that's probably why I've forgotten what I actually did in the last cut, apart from digging out all of this, or starting digging out at least. But back to the point, the reason I'm doing the ladder thing is because it's much easier than having like a gate or a fence gate or a door or something like that, or even a piston door, whatever it is. That's not as effective because sheep can definitely still escape, of course, because if you go in with the fence gate, then they can escape. Whereas with the ladders, wow, I'm getting a lot of lag. With the ladders, you can't have any risk of sheep escaping, unless, of course, sheep climb ladders, which I seriously doubt they do. I hope they do. I hope they don't. I hope they don't climb ladders. Oh, God. Okay, so some more progress has been made here, and as you can see, I've got myself a little bit of a design, which I think is pretty good right here. So this is a design for how the walls are going to look, and I think if, you know, everything was filled up with these kind of walls, it would look pretty cool. And this design is both simple and it also looks pretty cool because of the stone and just the wood. That is all I'm using in this. As I say, this is the same kind of material scheme that I use everywhere in this area. Wherever you look, you'll see cobblestone and oak wood and that kind of stuff. But it also means I'm going to have to smelt up a lot of stone, which is what I'm doing right over here. And I've also used the old lava bucket thing, so I can keep topping these up as quickly as possible. So I actually get the most stone out of them and use the lava to the most efficiency that I can. But you've probably noticed all of these little holes and stuff here. These are going to be for the lighting options. And I think I'm just going to put a bit of glowstone in each of these, and that should look pretty cool. But now what I've got to do is go ahead and repeat this pattern all the way around the whole thing. And also what I've got here is a really simple way to actually get in some added functionality here. So you can actually get into the pens really easily now. So you don't need to necessarily always use the ladders. You can just use them to get out, and you can just fall in from the outside here. And I hope these sheep can't escape because, you know, it's really tricky sometimes to stop animals from escaping from when you've sort of fenced them in. It's really tricky because if you have something like this, then obviously the animals can go on top of here, and then if you had like a block like this, then they'd be able to climb out of there and into another pen on top of the fences and stuff. So I have to be really careful. All of these single block pillars that we have, I'm going to actually extend them slightly higher up into the walkway thing that's going to be here, because they're going to support the walkway on the top. So now, like I say, I've got to go and extend this thing around, and it should be looking pretty awesome by the next cut. Oh no, not again, oh god, the mobs, they always get me. Oh, no, I knew it. That was not planned, I'm not even lying, that was not planned. This is just typical. And trust me, there were a lot more mob attacks than that. I had like 4 creepers come and attack me and blow up my lovely creation here. I literally counted 4 different isolated creeper incidents here, and that's obviously because all of the area out there is unlit, so they keep pouring in to our farm, but we'll change that pretty soon. I'm going to extend the walls around our farm, and as we build more stuff in this area, stuff will be lit up with all of the torches like it is here, and we'll get less mob spawning. But this thing is looking pretty cool, really nice. I've finished up adding in all the border and all that kind of stuff. This is the only way I actually can get in and out of this thing, because the walls are too high. So that proves that the sheep shouldn't escape from here, and hopefully these mobs can't either. And now what I've got to do is add in all of the fence posts going in between all of these pillars and on top of these wood posts. So these guys are clever. They found the way out, but not for long, hopefully. Oh, maybe not. This is what I mean. There's been a lot of mobs incidents around here. But away from that, what I need to do now is add in the fence posts, like I say, and then add in all of these walkways. And thinking about it now, I'm actually going to have to get rid of these bits of stone brick slabs. And yeah, I'm going to have these walkways going all the way along, and hopefully then it should be easy to get in and out of these pens. And the thing that I said about dropping in like this, it obviously only works for the pens on the outside row. It doesn't work for this one on the inside, but I guess that's not really too much of a problem, because we can use the walkways to get in. So I've got to go and do that. But I've also had another little bit of an idea. And I had this idea a while back, but I didn't really get enough time, or pretty much forgot about it. So I didn't implement it into the design. But the idea here is that I want to have, obviously, different colors of wool in different pens. And that means it would be really cool to kind of color code all of the pens. And don't really know how I'm exactly going to do that, because I want a really easy to see way of knowing which color goes in which pen. And I think what it's going to involve is just putting like two bits of wool, one... Okay, right, let me get rid of these mobs, then I can explain it to you properly. I think it's going to involve like putting two bits of wool in the walls here. I'm going to like put one there and one there in each kind of section. So I'd have... I wouldn't need it here, but I could actually even put it in on like all of the walls. So I have a really easy to see... kind of labeling of all of these pens, and I know which color each of the pens will give me, which color of wool. Whoa, that was a really weird shot there, almost went flying into the air. But I'm gonna get on with that. Not the wool thing, I think I'm gonna leave that till last, once I actually have the sheep in there, and then I can actually add in the different wool colors in the walls. But that's another thing, this farm isn't going to be that useful unless we actually have some sheep in there, and that's going to be the next thing after all these fences and the walkways that I'm actually going to have to do, and that is definitely going to be a bit of a challenge. Just as I expected, the fences placement didn't take too long. The fences placement, is that even a good way of saying it? Probably not, but placing the fences didn't take too long, and now I'm coming up with a little bit of a design here. With the fences, by the way, it looks pretty cool. I chose oak fences because that's just the type of wood that we're using, and it's pretty much what I've used all over the place around this area. So pretty much going to be sticking with oak wood fences. And what I should probably do is go ahead quickly and make myself some ladders to show you what I'm going to do next. So you see I've started building out the platformy things, the walkways is what I was calling them before, and it's going to work like this. So we've got these little wooden posts here, and I'm just going to put some ladders on the sides of those, and that's going to be our way in now, and it's going to be as simple as that. One on either side, obviously, to get into either pen, and this is how it's going to be. It's going to be just a stone brick slab line running along all the way to the end, like I was saying, and I think it should work pretty good. I'm not sure how it looks, really. Maybe I should add in some extra detail. Maybe I should do something with stairs, or actually that's on the lower half of the block, so it probably won't work out to replace that block with a stair, but I might be able to do something like this, which would probably look good. Yeah, that doesn't look too bad. Maybe I should do this, I don't know. It's probably going to take a little bit of experimenting and figuring out what to do here, but this seems to look okay. This looks okay. So far, I'm pretty satisfied with this project, actually, but I think the hard bit is going to be obviously getting in all of the sheep. That is going to be the really hard bit, and that doesn't even look good, actually, because these ones are sort of facing inwards and these ones are facing outwards, and that just kind of makes it look a bit weird. So I think I'm going to get rid of these. But I could probably keep the other ones, and now I at least have a really easy way of getting in and out of here, and it's started raining. Great. Why do you have to spoil the weather? Why does Minecraft have to do this? Wow, who put rain into Minecraft? Was it Notch? Because that was a bad idea, Notch. Seriously. No, I'm joking. Actually, no, I actually don't mind the rain sometimes, but today is not a good day for rain, but I don't know what I'm talking about anymore, so I should probably just carry on with this, bring it out, and do the same thing on this side as well, so we can get into the pens on the far side, or at least get out of them really easily, because of course we can just jump into them from the top ends now. And once we've done that, I think we will probably be getting the sheep in, and that's going to be very interesting to watch, so stay tuned for that one. Okay, so judging by the fact that these angry zombies can't get out of there, that one's even got a sword, but they can't get out, so I'm pretty sure that the sheep won't be able to escape from these pens either. These guys can actually climb ladders though, so but that's if they're pushing on each other, I think, so that's probably not going to be too much of a problem. But yeah, all of the walkways are in. Take a look at this. It looks pretty awesome, and it also works pretty awesomely. It just looks really cool. I really love this design, this design idea, and it was something that, again, I didn't even use creative mode for, which I'm really proud of. And I think I missed a block over here. Oh no, this is the wool color coding design thing that I had before, but I obviously couldn't get the wool in just yet. But if you take a look here, I've added in some slabs in between the cobblestone stairs that I was placing earlier. So it kind of looks like these are struts holding up the walkway there in the middle, and like I say, it's really, really easy to just go up onto the walkway using the ladders when all the sheep are just like running around down there. They're not going to be a problem, and in this case, we have creepers here now too. But once we light up the area, and once we have glowstone in each of these, and once we maybe even put some glowstone in the middle, like I'll put one block of glowstone maybe in the middle as well, then we're not going to have any mob problems whatsoever. And I think this has just been looking so cool, and I pretty much underestimated all of the stone that we're actually going to need for this build, because you see I've pretty much got like all of my stone supplies here and some dirt as well. But that's probably because in the last episode we were building that awesome thing over there, the brilliant railway and the railway station. If you haven't checked out that episode, please be sure to go and check that one out. You'll probably enjoy it. It was really a lot of fun to make that thing, and I'm probably going to be riding it a little bit as well. To get to the spawn chunks, and we also have a few first, like I think my first module over there is filled up with iron, so that's all looking good. But now the hard part is arriving. Oh, I don't even know how I'm going to do this. I think it's going to involve a lot of leads, and yeah, you know exactly what it is. This is a sheep farm, but there's something missing. It's a sheep. It's a sheep. We need to get the sheep in, and that is going to take a very long time indeed. So I better get started. So it turns out that it's going to be easier than I thought to actually get the sheep into the pens. I'm obviously going to need lots and lots of white sheep, but I'm also going to need some other sheep like this, these light grey sheep and the grey sheep and other colours like that. These guys are all escaping by the looks of it. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, I don't really care anyway, because obviously I'm making another farm now. Now I've used up all of my leads. That was stupid. I don't even know how I managed to do that. Let me take off the leads off all of these guys and try and do this properly. Take off that lead and take off that one. I unfortunately don't have that many slime blocks, slime balls, everything to do with slime, because I can't find any slimes anywhere anymore. And obviously leads use slimes, which is why I need to be more careful with them. But yeah, it's a lot easier than I thought. I can actually just go to this existing sheep farm which I have over here and take these sheep from there. But the problem is that there are not many, sorry, white-wooled sheep inside there. Is there still a lead on this guy, or no? I don't think there's a lead on him. So I've already lost one lead over there somewhere. Well, I'll pick that up later. But there are not many white wool sheep, unfortunately. So what I'm actually going to have to do is go around the area in just a second and get all of those white wool sheep as well. See if I can actually get these guys inside here without taking any damage. I don't think they take any damage. So yep, that looks okay. Now this guy. Let me just pull this guy inside here. And I'm just going to be doing this. And by the next cut, I should hopefully have at least two sheep in each of these pens. And most of these sheep will be white, like I say. Some of them will be like this, like grey or light grey. And I'm obviously not going to change the colours of those sheep. But I'm going to dye. Wait, I think you can only dye white wool sheep. That's why I'm saying that I'm going to have to put them in each of the pens. But if you can dye the other sheep, that would be pretty amazing. So I should probably run a little bit of a test, and by the next cut, we should have some sheep in each of these pens. I have a feeling I'm gonna have to move my nether portal. So pretty soon I realized that I was being a little bit stupid, and you can actually dye any sheep any color. So I didn't need to go looking around for lots and lots of white sheep. I could just have any sort of sheep, and now all of the pens are filled up with all the different colors of sheep. But what I'm going to do is, in between episodes, I'm actually going to go and dye these sheep to the specific colors which I need. Some of them will be like black and gray and stuff, in the same pen, and that's obviously not going to remain the same way for too long. And I think we're gonna have to do some F5 mode fighting right now because of these zombies, unless they get trapped inside the pens, which would be really cool. But also the little labeling system for the wall colors and things that I was gonna do originally. I don't think I'm gonna do that anymore because there's not really much point. I mean, you can just look inside the pen and see like there's black sheep there and there's grey sheep there. It's obviously gonna give you grey wool. You don't really need a kind of labeling system, so I'm not gonna do that anymore, and I don't really think I need to. And like I was saying at the start of the episode, I did want to keep it like as short as possible this time. And I sort of failed in that, to be honest. I was aiming for 20 minutes and it turned into pretty much half an hour, I think. But there's nothing I could do about that. I did try my absolute best, but maybe next episode I can do a little bit better. And by the way, the little thing in the Nether there was because my Iron Titan portal had got linked up with my portal in my Nether hub. So my Nether hub portal had been linked up with my Iron Titan portal, and that means that all of the roses from there, or the poppies, are being launched into my Nether hub, which is pretty annoying. It's going to cause a lot of lag down there in the Nether, but more than lag, I actually fired a ghast fireball. I actually hit a ghast fireball, which was aimed at me, to a zombie pigman. So now all of them are angered in the Nether. So I'm probably not going to survive there for much longer unless I get a little bit geared out. But enough of that because I think we're going to be ending the episode right here today. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to completely finish the farm, but I did add in all of the glowstone. And by finish the farm, I mean actually dyeing up all of the sheep and breeding them. But I'll do that in between episodes. So hopefully, next episode, you guys will get to see that. And if you did enjoy this one, then please be sure to leave a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then also go ahead, feel free to subscribe. And also, you might want to check out some of the other episodes if you really did like this one. But I think that's enough from me for today. Enough talking. And thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.